Brakes are arguably the most important part of your vehicle. Without them functioning properly, it could put you and anyone else on the road at danger. Today, I'm going to show you the telltale signs that your brakes need replacing. Whether it's rotors, pads, hoses, brake fluid, or even calipers. And as always, we have a ton of DIY showing you how to do brake jobs on your own vehicle. For starters, let's start with the most basic one, which is gonna be brake pad wear sensors. You're probably more than familiar with the little red light on your dash telling you brake light or brake or low brakes. And that's gonna be due to these little guys right here. Brake pad wear sensors are responsible for notifying you when your brake pads are due for replacement. Some of these are two-stage sensors, meaning that they have the first contact point that wears out or rips as you wear through the sensor and the pad, giving you a little tap on the shoulder, letting you know, hey, you want to consider doing your brake soon. The light goes away. It was just a gentle reminder. Maybe you go out there and do a visual inspection or note it down. The second stage in these sensors are going to give you the full red light on the cluster, letting you know, hey, it's time to change your brakes, whether that's pads, rotors. The only thing it won't tell you necessarily is whether it's the front or the rear. So you're gonna have to do some investigating, which we'll show you how to do in just a moment. Next on our list of what ifs and or maybes is gonna be the actual brake disc itself, your brake rotor. Over time, these will age, they can rust, and they start to warp in extreme cases. The first thing you can do is simply a visual inspection. Is there a lot of rust on the hub portion? Is there a lot of rust on the vanes? Is it flaking away? Do they look horrible? That is going to be enough to tell you how long they have been on there, especially if you don't know the service history of your vehicle. The next thing you can do, and only do this while the vehicle is nice and cool, is run your fingernail across the surface of the disc, whether it's the inboard or outboard side of the rotor. If there's a lip developing on either end, that's going to indicate to you that they've worn away quite a bit. And the most obvious that you can tell when driving is simply getting on the brakes hard, and if you get any vibration or pulsation at the steering wheel, just keep in mind that that can sometimes also be worn out control arms, bushings, or even a bad wheel bearing, which hopefully you'll hear before you start to feel. Moving on in the brake system, the next part of our brake sandwich, if you will, is gonna be the pads. The pads are responsible for clamping down on the brake disc and slowing your vehicle down. This is what wears away. This also wears away the surface of the rotor. They work hand in hand with the brake disc and the caliper, getting your car to a complete stop. These will last you average 40 to 60,000 miles, depending on the kind of car you drive and the kind of driving you do. Obviously, a large, heavy SUV, that's gonna be on the shorter end of that spectrum, maybe even less. A small car that you just commute in day to day, don't do any heavy driving or track time, they're gonna probably last you on the longer side of that scale. Obviously, a visual inspection is gonna tell you what kind of condition those pads are in or how much life is left in them. The next best thing, if you really wanna check, is measuring the actual thickness of the pad. Let's head over to this Mini and I can show you exactly how to do that. This is a manual brake gauge set. This is a CTA set available on fcpro.com. You can see we have green, yellow, and red gauges. The 2 millimeter is typically the recommended, most critical change your brake pads measurement that you can have on pretty much any vehicle across the board. Obviously 12 millimeter being the greatest is gonna be brand new, no need to change. In order to use one of these gauges, you wanna A, take a look at the vehicle, see kind of what you have going on. I'm gonna start with the 10 mil gauge. And these are super simple. That way, if you don't believe the guy at the quick oil change shop that told you, hey, you need new brakes, or the dealership, you can take a look and measure for yourself. Grabbing the gauge, you're gonna take the flat portion, butt that up against the surface of the disc, and try to get it between the disc and the backing plate of the pad. In this case, the 10 mil is too big. It doesn't fit in, meaning we have less than 10 mil worth of pad material left. So I'm gonna go on to the next one, which is gonna be the 8 mil. And that one seats in perfectly fine. So we have about 9 millimeters left of pad material left, which is well in spec and safe for this car to continue operating on the road. And for those of you that have vehicles that don't have brake pad wear sensors, or you don't have a gauge set to measure the thickness of the pad, but you're still curious on how you're gonna know whether or not your brakes are low, some of these pads are equipped with a wear indicator tab, if you will, a little metal tab that sits off one of the ears. And as they start to get low, they're going to get closer and closer to the disc. Once they come in contact with the disc, they're going to start squeaking or grinding. Obviously, grinding is going to be the worst case example of that situation. But the squeaking is going to come in, and you're definitely not going to be able to miss it. Another thing that applies to brakes that most people don't often think about is the brake fluid and the hoses. These are super critical, as this is a high pressure system that has a ton of hydraulic fluid running through it. And every time you press on that brake pedal, the hoses and the fluid are responsible for actuating the caliper piston, squeezing down the pads on your discs. Hoses, over time, just like any rubber component on any vehicle, can break down. Whether they burst a leak or they clog up on the inside and swell up, causing the fluid to not travel either in or out of the caliper. So keep that in mind. Usually 100,000 miles or every 10 years is a good average replacement for these. Just as important as hydraulic lines are, the hydraulic fluid that runs through them is even more important. This is probably one of the most overlooked aspects of any vehicle's braking system. Brake fluid is something that should be replaced every 2 years, no matter how many miles you're driving, as it is hydroscopic. And once it starts absorbing moisture, not only can it ruin the components of your braking system, but it can also affect the pedal field. Old brake fluid can give for a soft, mushy pedal, which in return gives poor braking performance. And last but not least in this whole system is going to be your actual brake caliper itself. This is the bad boy responsible for doing the clamping on the disc and pads, bringing your vehicle to a stop. The second you press on that brake pedal, hydraulic fluid travels through the system, through the lines, to the caliper, to the back of this piston, pushing the piston out onto the pads, which squeeze your brake disc. And just like any other vehicle part, rubber in these calipers can also degrade over time. You have seals and dust boots that can fail, allowing for moisture and debris to get in, damaging the components inside of the caliper. Rusting can affect the surface of the piston. It can cause pitting, which allows leaks, and so on and so forth. So keeping these not only clean when you wash your vehicle, but just keeping an eye on them every time you do a brake job, pushing your pistons back in properly, just servicing the brakes properly in general can go a long way in enhancing the life of your brake disc calipers. And something worth noting, even though it's not pictured here, are vehicles equipped with drum brakes. Those have brake shoes inside of them, similar to a pad in a curved shape that sits inside of a brake drum. We have a wheel cylinder, which much like a brake caliper, has rubber bits inside of it that expand and over time can fail or degrade, causing a leak and a brake failure. So those need the same service and attention that these systems do, even though they're a little bit more archaic. Another thing to consider when looking at your caliper and the condition of the caliper is the condition of how the items inside of it are wearing, meaning the pads and the disc that it's clamping on. Are the pads wearing evenly? Are they uneven? Is one side of the rotor chewed up and the other side perfectly fine? That could be a telltale sign that the caliper itself is not functioning properly and it can be getting hung up or not clamping down all the way, which again can be a bad caliper, a bad seal, a bad line, bad brake fluid, all of the above. So keeping those serviced and maintained properly is going to be a huge plus to the longevity of your braking system and its performance. Again, this is the most crucial and safety part of your vehicle, aside from the actual tires that connect the vehicle to the ground. So if you have good brakes, you're more than halfway there. And last but not least, worth mentioning as far as the safety and stopping power of your braking system goes, is your ABS pump, if equipped, and brake booster and master cylinder. Those are components that we have covered in multiple DIYs where we show you how they operate and how they can get replaced. So if you're curious on checking that out, be sure to check the DIYs in our channel. We hope this video helped you out a bit in determining how and when to replace your brakes. Hopefully you learned a thing or two. If you did, please be sure to give this video a thumbs up. If you have any questions or comments related to the braking system on your vehicle, please be sure to leave us a comment in the comment section below. And if you like this quick explanation and you want to even watch a DIY on how to do your own brakes at home, please consider subscribing. We make new videos all the time. As always, thank you so much for watching. We'll catch you on the next one.